Discussion of cardiology multiple choice questions. Modified Blalock torsic shunt is 1. End-to-side anastomosis of subclavian artery to a pulmonary artery. 2. Side-to-side anastomosis of main pulmonary artery to aorta. 3. Side-to-side anastomosis of subclavian artery to a pulmonary artery using a conduit. 4. Anastomosis of superior vena cava to right pulmonary artery. Correct answer, side-to-side anastomosis of subclavian artery to a pulmonary artery using a conduit. In classic Blalock torsic shunt, the subclavian artery is divided and anastomosed to the pulmonary artery as an end-to-side anastomosis. In modified Blalock torsic shunt, a Gore-Tex graft is used to connect the subclavian artery to the pulmonary artery. In Davidson shunt, a Gore-Tex graft is used to connect ascending aorta to main pulmonary artery. Glenn shunt connects the superior vena cava to right pulmonary artery. Schematic diagram of modified Blalock torsic shunt in a person with right aortic arch and tetralogy of Fallot. Complication of Fontan procedure. 1. Plastic bronchitis. 2. Protein losing enteropathy. 3. Heart failure. 4. All of the above. 5. None of the above. Correct answer, 4. All of the above. Heart failure was the mode of death in 34% in a series of 600 adult Fontan survivors. Arrhythmia or sudden death was the reason in 24%. Protein losing enteropathy is an important complication of Fontan circulation. Atrioventricular wall regurgitation is often associated with ventricular failure and it can be progressive. Pleural effusion, chylothorax, and plastic bronchitis are important pulmonary complications associated with Fontan circulation. Predisposition to thrombosis and thromboembolism are also well known. It contributed to 7.9% of the late deaths in one study. Gold standard for myocardial viability. 1. Systolic thickening of myocardial segment on echocardiography. 2. Absence of late gadolinium enhancement on magnetic resonance imaging. 3. Preserved metabolic activity on positron emission tomography. 4. Myocardial scar detected on multi-detector computed tomography. Correct answer, 3. Preserved metabolic activity on positron emission tomography. Preserved metabolic activity on positron emission tomography is considered the gold standard in myocardial viability assessment. Segmental thickening and absence of scarring detected by other imaging modalities are also useful indicators of viability. Wrong statement about coronary subclavian steel syndrome. 1. Occurs after CABG using left internal mammary artery. 2. Diversion of blood flow from coronary circulation to exercising left upper limb. 3. High-grade stenosis or occlusion of left subclavian artery distal to the origin of lima. 4. Can manifest with angina. Correct answer, 3. High-grade stenosis or occlusion of left subclavian artery distal to the origin of lima. Coronary subclavian steel syndrome occurs when there is a high-grade stenosis or occlusion of left subclavian artery proximal to the origin of lima. Cardiovascular manifestation of coronary subclavian steel syndrome could be angina, myocardial infarction, malignant arrhythmias, or heart failure. Cerebral symptoms can occur due to steel from the cerebral circulation through the vertebral artery. Which of the following is not a usual feature of acute aortic regurgitation? 1. Long and loud diastolic murmur. 2. Mitral valve pre-closure. 3. Peripheral signs of AR not seen. 4. Diastolic mitral regurgitation may occur. Correct answer, 1. Long and loud diastolic murmur. The classical decrescendo early diastolic murmur and peripheral signs of chronic aortic regurgitation are not features of acute AR. An early diastolic murmur, if heard, is usually softer and shorter in acute AR. High left ventricular diastolic pressure causes mitral valve pre-closure. But when the left ventricular diastolic pressure becomes very high in severe acute AR, mitral valve reopens in late diastole, causing diastolic mitral regurgitation. Which was the phase 3 trial of Selexipag, a drug for treatment of pulmonary hypertension? 1. TASTE trial, 2. PRAMI trial, 3. GRIFFON trial, 4. VITAL trial. Correct answer, 3. GRIFFON trial. TASTE trial was thrombus aspiration during ST elevation myocardial infarction. PRAMI was preventive angioplasty in myocardial infarction. VITAL trial was on role of vitamin D in cardiovascular disease. Wrong statement about third heart sound. 1. In mitral regurgitation, S3 need not indicate left ventricular dysfunction. 2. S3 occurs just after the opening of the atrioventricular valve. 3. It is due to rapid acceleration of transmitral blood flow as the ventricles fill. 4. It corresponds in timing to shortly after the peak of the early diastolic E wave of transmitral flow. Correct answer, 3. It is due to rapid acceleration of transmitral blood flow as the ventricles fill. Third heart sound occurs in early diastole due to rapid deceleration of transmitral blood flow as the ventricles fill. Takayasu arteritis is an inflammatory disorder affecting aorta and its major branches. Takayasu was 1. Vascular surgeon, 2. Ophthalmologist, 3. Physician, 4. Cardiologist. Correct answer, 2. Ophthalmologist. Takayasu was an ophthalmologist who noted characteristic fundal arteriovenous anastomosis in a young female in 1905 and published it in Acta of the Ophthalmic Society of Japan in 1908. Onishi and Kagosha described similar cases associated with absent radial pulses in the same year.